So, I have a love-hate relationship with this level.
When I first started speedrunning this game, this is my favourite level, and it really helped me fall in love with this run. It was so clever and challenging, yet it was always consistent and fun to learn. This level works more as a whole than most other levels, where things you pick up at the start play a role at the end, which has a very holistic feel to it. You can tell I'm a student, can't you? Anyway, I'm waffling here, let's move on to the routes. The first route is the old route, which I love. Pick up the wrench, pick up the key, turn the key, and fix the gen. The new route, which is more accepted, is pick up the wrench, then pick up the key, turn the key, pick up the banana, get a new wrench, and fix the gen. The new route may sound longer, but it's actually faster as you can multitask in the second to last room instead of doing it sequentially. And finally, number 3, the out of bounds route, which only a psychopath would attempt. Most of the strats used in routes 1 and 2 are the same, apart from the routing in that second to last room, so I'll explain them together. First, let's start with the simple stuff. Just simply throw the banana to the monkey and walk over to the gen. This is super easy and I never miss the... Huh? What do you mean? I've lost a minute to... Oh, yeah.
I don't know how they do it. It's weird.
No! I hate this fucking banana! Anyway, quick fix the gen and swap to Marion and jump over the gate. Then run to the right as Marion and push the cart to the left until the corner closest to you is in line with the rope, like this. Then run to the left, jump on the awning, jump across to the cart, then jump on the rope, and drop immediately onto the platform. Jump to the key, and then pick it up. And you know what time it is, it's strat split time. Like the first segment last episode, there is no time loss to either method, but it's personal preference, and this one is a little more divided. The first strat is to jump on the rope, then immediately jump off to the left, and phase halfway through the wall, and then you fall down, and you land on the oob layer below. This is my favourite of the two, as it's less precise than strat 2, and it's probably easier to learn. The other way is to jump to the left, to this spot here, then spam jump and move away from the camera. You should then be put behind the back wall, where you can loop back in and land on the oob layer. I used to do this one quite a lot, and a couple of problems with it, which is why I changed over, but I know quite a few runners who still use this one religiously, so feel free to use it. Now that you're on the oob layer, run back the way you came. Be careful not to phase back to the stairs, taking a fairly wide line to stay on top of the oob layer. Then, as you approach the door, jump right as Marion comes in line with it. You can tell when that is, with the icon above her head like so. Be aware that if you do this too late, you won't get the transition, and a common mistake is to just walk right back towards the transition, but this is what happens. And obviously, you don't want that. So, what you do instead is go to the right side of the corridor, then walk back to the transition. Learning this trick has saved about 3 or so runs for me, so it's definitely worth knowing. The next room is super easy. Just drop in Indy and sit in by the door, and with Marion, just pull the cart away. And here we are, strat split number 2. This one does save 3 seconds and a bit of hassle, so I'd recommend learning this one. So with strat 1, drop out Indy and run and jump as Marion over the enemies. Then at the top of the stairs, jump onto this wall here, and across the gap, and jump again over to this platform here. Then jump to the right and loop around behind the wall. Run across the left and jump up through the door. For the second strat, drop out player 2, then swap to Indy, then run and jump with him up the stairs, avoiding the enemies as much as you can. Try to stay above at least 2 hearts, then whip down the platform and an animation cancel by swapping to Marion. Then you jump onto the wire link fence, jump onto the platform, and up to the door. Both of these are pretty precise and tricky at first, but a bit of practice should do you good, and you'll get these 100% of the time. To start with, this room is easy, but it gets progressively harder as you go. Turn the spinner about halfway, and then jump onto the stairs. Then push the ball down, and the camera should lock. Use tag moving to get across the bridge and finish on Marion. You can then jump across this gap at a 45 degree angle, and continue to walk along the planks until the end. And this is the final strat split. This is essentially the difference between Route 1 and Route 2. In Route 1, turn the key until the bridge reaches the middle stud, then switch to Indy and jump across the gap. Whip on the panel, break the wall, build the bridge, and whip the box towards you. Place it on the green square and quick fix the gen. Then build the lever, jump on it as you finish, and launch yourself to the trapdoor. And for Route 2, you need a bit more 1P2C. As Marion, turn the key the same amount, then drop in Indy and jump across the gap. as Marion pick up the banana just before Indy whips across, and jump the gap as well. Throw the banana roughly halfway through the bridge being built, and walk to the left at the same time as Indy, then quick fix it while Indy places the box down. Once the gen is fixed, pick up the box with Indy and place it down. Then, build the lever with Marion, and move Indy next to the trapdoor. Jump onto the lever, and fall through as Indy. Now that is a lot of instructions, and it seems complicated, but a lot of the complicated movements are happening while the other player is still or completing an easy task. This will take a bit of time to learn, but once you get it right, you're saving 4-5 seconds using Route 2, so it's pretty useful. And for the final room, all three routes are exactly the same. Run to the right as Marion and jump off this sand pile to the roof area, then walk across this balcony, jump onto the railing, then do an anti-clockwise, or counterclockwise if you love freedom, jump into the pillar. You should then hit a platform, which you then jump off, past the back wall, loop back down to the oubliettes below the floor. Now this is a pretty complicated jump, so I practiced this one quite a bit as well, because it gets pretty frustrating when you can't get it over and over again. Trust me, I've been there. Then just run to the right, go onto the left wall of the gate, jump back up through, and you're done. Now as the end cutscene plays, I'm going to go back through some... What do you mean I have to explain Route 3? Oh, for f***. So, Route 3. Room 1 is the same, and Room 2 is where it all matters. This strategy is dependent upon this glitch, and unfortunately, it requires you just to get lucky. Essentially, you need the enemies to not be aggro on you. You can tell the difference in the music. And this works like any transition skip. Punch Indy with Marion, and use the same technique to get him through the door. And Room 5 is very different, and where you lose most of the time save you just got, really. The start is the same as both the other routes, until you get to the Monkey Zone. Remember the key that was so important to the first two routes? Yeah, you didn't get that at the start, so you have to get the key from the monkey. This loses about 5 seconds. Then follow roughly the same route as number 2, getting the wrench with Marion while Indy whips to the right and grabs the box. The final room is exactly the same as the rest of the routes. So, at the end of the day, Route 3 only saves 8 seconds across the level, and since it's so dependent on straight up RNG, it's really not that popular in full game runs, but feel free to go for it if you want. I know this guide was a bit longer than the last two, but this level, as I said at the start, has to be seen as a whole, so explaining it requires a bit more time and detail. There won't be another long one like this until Pancot Secrets, so for the next few weeks expect to see a guide every Sunday. World of Souls is a really short level, so the next video will be much shorter than this one, don't worry about that. And if you made it this far in the video, thank you very much for helping me out in the YouTube algorithm. If you want to help me more, then hit like and comment down below. Okay, see you guys next week. As Marion then going to pick up the banana. As Marion pick up the banana just before Indy whips across.